when you want to compete, yes, learn from it, do it better, because that's the only way we can be able to build our nation, Kenya. Mm. If all of us, we can take at a competition and then do better, we can be able to build up our nation. DJ,
hey,
come
on. Hey, how are you, man?
How are you, man?
Is it salam?
Yes, yeah. And then you keep your distance.
So this, hey, yeah, keep
your distance. And then, but then, DJ.
Yes, yes.
Hey, lazima we sanitize.
Oh,
hey,
is it sharia?
Yeah, sharia. Sanitize.
Wakubali kutufungulia.
Sanitize, sanitize.
Yes.
You must sanitize.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, amazing. Mm. Yes. This thing we shall overcome. Mm-hmm. We shall overcome.
And naona wanasemanga lazima ufanye
hivyo. You sanitize. Yeah, you sanitize.
Yes.
Well, good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Fantastic.
How are you?
And of course, all our viewers.
Yes.
Hey, I think we are happy. Maybe we are kwanza.
Tuko salama kabisa. But before you,
yes.
Acha kwanza ikae kwa mfuko.
DJ.
Yes.
Hapa nasema ni low risk.
Eh.
Tuko kwa kishaka.
Yes.
Tutoe hiki kitu.
Ah, yes.
Hey, tuongee vizuri.
Tuongee vizuri. Yes. Yangu nitaiweka kwa mfuko.
Eh, hey, hata mimi.
Naogopa na gilai.
Hapana, na gilai imeokoka.
Hamjambo, great people. Natumai mko salama. Yes, tuko Kiambu, Amani, the place of peace. And I tell you, yani, hata vile nimekaa hapa hivi, ningeitisha sasa kinywaji, lakini niko na maji. Karibuni sana, tell a friend and tell a friend that we are Facebook Live at DJ Covenant, at George Wachiuri. Na leo tuko na zawadi kemkem, na pia tutakueleza mengi, a lot of things that we have for you in store, zile ambazo utakuwa ukipata. But before then, allow me to introduce our able and lovely servant, ambaye anajiita Mr. George Wachiuri. Karibu sana.
Asante sana DJ Covenant.
Yes.
And thank you so much all our viewers. I know that people are watching us all over the world. We are here at Amani Ridge, the place of peace. And DJ Covenant, we are so, so happy that our followers are always with us, and we are happy. And DJ Covenant, I don't know whether you, when you are coming, you see the kind of work happening, mm-hmm, as you come in.
Yes.
And of course, ukifika pale, unaona lebo yenyewe.
And I tell you, this is the Solomonic Gate.
Solomonic Gate. I think DJ Covenant, our viewers,
yes,
there is no other gate,
mm-hmm,
in this republic,
yes,
actually East and Central Africa,
yes,
like this gate.
None.
And by the way, DJ Covenant,
yes,
Kenyans are good people.
Mm-hmm.
Kenyans are aggressive. And mm-hmm, Kenyans are intelligent. This gate is not done by China.
Mm-hmm.
This gate is done by a Kenyan, educated in our colleges, in our university. This is a Kenyan product.
Mm-hmm.
And you are watching us. Buy Kenya, build Kenya.
Yes. Hey. You know, I was telling, I won't mention, but I was telling Mr. George, I was somewhere in a meeting and people referred to this gate. And they were saying, so this gate is a landmark, like we're saying, East and Central Africa, none like this one. So, Asansana, and how do you feel after we were, you know, before we were just talking?
Yes.
Yeah, we were there in the when you were doing our the previous teachings.
Yes.
We were saying Solomonic Gate, and you are the only one who was having this picture.
Wow.
But today, it's
wow,
evident. Here it is.
DJ Covenant, number one, I thank God.
Yes.
Because God is the one who gives us energy, the power to do this work.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, I thank the Optiven. We don't call them employees, call them partners.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is a product of Optiven. People working for Optiven doing this particular kind of project. And I also thank our customers, because our customers have trusted Optiven.
Mm.
And we are so happy that the customers are becoming every day. We are hosting customers here. And even as we do this particular show, customer wako huko wanaona mashamba.
Yes.
You know, it's amazing to see how a vision can be supported by the employees, the partners, by the customers, and by the grace of God. And that's why today, DJ Covenant, we are very excited talking, mm-hmm, about the green spaces.
Yes.
Talking about the sustainable development goals number 7, whereby we must be able to have sustainable energy.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we're saying that we are using green energy. And of course, SDG number 11, whereby we must make our cities habitable. Our cities must be good for our people.
Mm-hmm.
And DJ Covenant, remember, I saw some research from the UN. They are saying by the year 2050, 70% of the global population, they'll be living in cities.
Wow.
That means Optiven, we are in the right place to ensure that our people are living in habitable conditions.
Today we have a very interesting topic, how to manage stress. I know it's a hard time, a lot of things are happening. I know there's a lot of pain, and now we want at least to put a lot more information on how we can deal with that. Let's begin here. What causes stress?
Wow, thank you, DJ Covenant. Thank you, our viewers. And I know that we are not ignorant that most of our viewers are undergoing challenges. They are undergoing stresses. Some are not even sure about tomorrow. Some don't have even food to eat because of this particular pandemic. Because of all these challenges, we have seen stress building up. And today we'll be discussing on how, what are some of these causes of stress, especially for our people out there. One of the causes of this particular stress is definitely ambition with zero action. There are people out there, they have their own ambition. Maybe they want to be the best in media, they want to be the best in real estate, they want to be the best in their particular career, the best accountant. But you ask them, are you taking any action? They don't take any action. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you, even if your ambition is so big like an elephant, or as fast as a cheetah, mm-hmm. if you don't take action, let me tell you, you keep thinking in your mind, and the stress will keep coming because you have the big dreams, but those brief dreams are not backed with everything. Mm. Maybe you're watching us from the US, from Europe, from Kenya. What is your ambition? And are you taking action? Maybe you have a dream. You are seeing this particular gate and say, hey, George, how can I get a property in a man reach the place of peace? If you don't take that action of calling and asking and telling us, can I pay on installment? We give you 2 years to pay. So it remains a dream. It remains an ambition. Mm-hmm. DJ Coven, that's number one. Number two, the cause of stress in our communities, in our societies, in our government, in our businesses, in our careers. Number two is what I call comparison and no benchmarking. Where kazi yako ni compare DJ Covenant and yourself. Please, I urge people that listen to me. Don't compare yourself with other people. Don't compare with your businesses with other people's businesses. Compare yourself with yourself and ask yourself, how can I be better, maybe in my skills? How can I be better in my talents? How can I make myself better? And once you compare yourself with yourself, you can only go a benchmark. Mm-hmm. Use people to benchmark.
Yes.
For example, for us at real estate, we say there are people that this year, they made almost $1 billion. And for us at Optiven, we say maybe these are the people we are benchmarking with. We do not even bother with other people who do real estate because we are not comparing ourselves with others. Mm-hmm. We compare ourselves with the giants. And for you who is watching us today, use other people or organization or SMEs to benchmark. Those are my 2 points and I have 5 points, DJ Covenant.
Wow, excellent. Tell a friend and tell a friend that we are Facebook Live. And I know right now people are now starting to see, yes, I think that's the place that I've been missing. Let's continue with the other points.
Well, we thank all people who are watching. Please do a watch party. Tell people that we are live here at Manage the Place of Peace. Mm-hmm. And of course, we are discussing the causes, the 5 causes of stress, the 5 causes of disturbance in our own lives, in our families, in our career, in our businesses. Number three, we talked about the ambition without action. That was number one. We talked about comparing yourself with other people or comparing your business with others. Number three is competition and not learning. My goodness. There are people, their job is just competition, and they don't learn from the competition. You have to go out there and say, wow, this is what I want to do. If you're looking for a project to manage, so don't feel kewaru here. When you want to compete, learn from it. Do it better, because that's the only way we can be able to build our nation, Kenya. If all of us, we can check at our competition and then do better, we can be able to build up our nation. Our nation can be better for everyone. And we said earlier, lazima tutegeneze kazi kwa watu wetu. Number four, DJ Covenant, the cause of stress. Number four, forgetting the usage of the word pest. Hey, do you know what is pest? Yani unasahau, the usage of the word pest. Today, families at home, they are fighting. Today, people are not able to progress to the next level. And this word called pest is actually please, excuse me, thank you, and sorry. So when you have done something wrong to your employer, for example, just do an email and say, I am sorry. The usage of the word pest can make our society better, can make our organizations better, can make our friendships better, the usage of the word pest. But many people, they forget to use the word pest. Unakuta tu wanapigana, especially the young people who just got married. You know, right now, maybe the job is over. Na muna zozana kwa nyumba. Yet, if you use this word called pest, let me tell you, even if you don't have food for the evening, you find there is peace in that particular family, there is peace in that particular organization, and things can be made better. Number five, our viewers, number five, the fifth cause of stress in our organization, in our societies, in our careers, in our lives, is lack of focus. My goodness. If you don't have focus, any direction will get you there. So ensure that in your own life, what are you meant to do? How can you make the world a better place? What is that particular thing that God created you to do? What is your focus? I know thousands and thousands of people are checking on us. Do you have a notebook whereby you write, this is my vision, this is my focus? And once you do that, DJ Covenant, we are going to reduce this rate of people committing suicide, people fighting in their homes, and people having unfair competition. I always say that you need to have what I call the abundance mentality. We have sufficient resources for everyone. Today, real estate is so big. So what you are doing at Optiven is a drop in the ocean. So if you are there, you want to start a business in real estate, please start it. If you are there, you want to start a business in hospitality, start it, because the opportunities, especially in Kenya, is massive. Opportunities in Africa is massive. That's why DJ Covenant, we have Chinese coming here. We have Germans coming here. In fact, they are asking, if epidemic, inaisha lini tukuje. In fact, I'm told they have now authorized planes to be coming to Kenya. And you see, P.S. Matiang'i was saying, we cannot behave as if we are dead. We open up our economy. And that's why we are also urging the government, open up this particular economy so that our people can be able to go out there and work. Don't be depressed. Don't be stressed.
Wow. I hope you're taking note of these notes, because these are very important points that you need to know. And because now we know where the stress is coming from. I know the other point is, now after you've known that, now is your question is, how do we overcome stress? I know that is the question that someone is asking out there. How do we overcome stress?
Wow, thank you. Thank you, our viewers. And we are discussing about how to manage stress or to overcome stress, because these are reality in life. And I'll share with you a few things that personally I do, and you can also do them, and you can be able to be better, you can be able to be positive, you can be able to have that original energy that you used to have, because stress reduces the energy, reduces the morale. So you need to go back to where you are. And one of the things you can do is to plan short term, you plan medium term, and also plan long term. So that book that I always tell the people I mentor to have, the journal, do you have in that particular book your short-term plans for the next 1 year, 6 months? What do you want to achieve? The medium-term plans, what are you planning about investment, for example? The long-term, are you planning to have your own house, for example? So that planning gives you some comfort, and don't wait for you to have money for you to plan. You can plan. Somebody told me that vision attracts provision. When you have a vision, resources will come from the south, from the north, from the west, from the east. But if you have no vision, you'll be there waiting. Resources don't appear. Number two, how to overcome stress. I say in a whisper, marry the right person.
Yes. Le shepai.
Marry the right person. Be in the right career.
Yes.
Do the right business. That's how to manage. We have thousands of people who married the wrong people. We have people there doing the wrong businesses. We have people there who are not even able, when they hear it's Monday morning, they are going to that particular organization, wanapata stress. That's why I saw some statistics. Many people die of stroke on Mondays. Can you imagine? Monday, ukiamuka, you are going to that particular organization, you say, I am already tired. So for you to manage that stress, to overcome that particular stress, do the right things. Even young people who are listening to us, maybe you are selected to join a certain college. Are you happy with that particular course? You can change it. We are now living in a situation whereby you can be able to change your career. Number three, how to manage stress. Prayer. Why, my goodness, prayer and meditation. Yani maombi. Every human being requires a superpower, a power somewhere. And for us who are Christians, we have God in heaven. So once you rise up in the morning, pray in the morning. In the evening, pray. Those who don't pray, meditate. And that one can really kill, can reduce the stress. Number four, this is very easy. Exercise. Yeah, we fanya mazoezi too. That's why this particular project called Amanilich.
Yes.
Our roads are 18 meters. We are also going to do the jogging track so that people, families are going to come here. We do not want stress. And of course, traveling. You know, don't just stay at home. Right now, people are working from home. There are people who have been in the house when I got COVID for 24/7. Can you imagine? Since March, my friend, utakufia kwa hiyo nyumba. Walk around. See the environment. See how the nature is. Come to Amanilich, the place of peace. See the way things are done here. And of course, how to manage stress. Number five, positive talk. Positive talk. Talk well about yourself. Talk well about your family, DJ Covenant. Talk well about your country. You know, there are people, they are Kenyans. Na wengine wanasikiza. But their job is just to criticize the government, to criticize the country. Kwani utahama, utaenda wapi? You cannot go to Trump. Hata hakuna mandege za kuenda huko. And wherever you are, if you are in the Trump land, please don't criticize that particular country. Hapo diyo uko. Anthony, come now. Uko hapo US. That's where you are.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Christine, you are there in Europe. Don't criticize. Have a positive talk. Say, this is a place that God has given me. I am going to earn this money. And this money, I invest this money at Optiven. Hii pesa, mimi nashukua pale US, nashukua Europe, napeleka wapi? Amani Ridge. I would invest there. Positive talk. Even if your job is shaky, say, this job is going to help me to invest. When you are positive, something happens within your system. You become energetic, you become better. And most of us, we die early because we are all negative. Hata ukata mtu maso. Maso ni gumu. Because ni mtu negative. Maso yake ni gumu. Hata kikuza hivi na kukwaruza. Because the guy is full of negativity. Let's decide to be positive. In our own homes, DJ Covenant.
Yes.
Even our children. Let's teach them on how they can become positive. Easy. This thing is a game changer. The same with organization like Optiven. Optiven is one of the most positive organizations I've ever seen. The people are the most positive. Can you imagine? Our customers are the most positive. And that's why we have this particular program. To train you, to coach you, to be a better person. Wow. Yes, DJ Covenant.
Wow. Sijui ni wangapi ambao they have very hard muscle. I know, najua, when you mentioned I wanted to touch myself, nikakumbuka tuko hewani. But you see, negativity brings all that.
I tell you.
And you know, it's, and I tell you, if you want someone to listen to this, make sure you tag them, because this is very, very important to listen to. And you know, I know a lot of stress is happening.
Yes.
And it's left, right. Na mtu wezi akasema ati yendi akona stress peke yake.
No.
Everyone is having stress.
I tell you.
Mm.
Allow me to share a few more tips on how to manage this stress, because I've been getting communication. I've been getting a text. George, how can I overcome depression? How can I overcome the stress? Number 5 or number 6? Let go. There are so many people. Maybe somebody alikukosea last year.
Yes.
And you still have that burden. Let go. Let that burden go. Maybe you lost a job. You have not forgiven your employer. Because I post some negative information on social media about your employer. Let me tell you, because young people are listening. Don't burn bridges. Even if your employer terminates you, you never know. Nowadays, companies have got a policy whereby when they're looking for people, even Optiven, people who left Optiven, we tell them, if you want to come back, you can come back. Don't burn bridges. You never know when you require that by a particular employer. So for you to manage this particular stress, let such things go. Release them. Don't hold there in your heart. Your heart is too small to hold so many things, so many grudges. Some of our people are parents. You say, I cannot forgive my father, my friend. Your father has no problem. Problem is you. You better forgive and get lighter. Of course, number 7, give. When you give, something happens. So keep giving. Even time like now, when there are families who are not able to sustain themselves, I thank the directors for Optiven. You know, this month alone, they have already given a portion of some resources to support the older generation, the people who are not able to feed for themselves. And there is a secret: when individuals, SMEs, corporates give back to the communities, because once you do that, you also reduce the kind of stress. And then the last one, reward yourself. There are so many people, they work so hard, but they have no time to reward themselves. They have no time to say, now, I've worked for a whole month. Today is Edmund.
Yes.
Yani, ata kuyunulia kahawa pale Panarottis. You just go to Panarottis or the spa. Useme, now, I'm eating ribs at Eagle Peak Spa in the hub. They cannot. They think when they are rewarding themselves, they are losing. My friend, where utaenda? Na hiyo mali yako itakuliwa. Ata before, mwisho ikukule. Goje ni wapatie bonus point.
Yes.
On how to manage stress. Rest. Create time to rest. Yes, DJ Covenant.
Wow, create time to rest.
Yes.
Very, very important.